Mr. Pervez Ahmed, lawyer representative of United Villages Human Rights Defenders. Over to you, Mr. Pervez Ahmed.
Thank you very much, for inviting me here. As you have already given the definition of the genocide, so I'm not going to touch it. First of all, I share the pain of the people of Sri Lanka who have been for the last couple of years condition and of the economic system systematically being eliminated and unfortunately the world conscience and the national community has not been any kind of attention to the system. Situation which is going on in Sri Lanka. I'm from Indian occupied Kashmir, which is under the occupation of India for the last 47 years, last 70 years of it. And I'm a son of the soil, but I had to flee from the Indian occupied Kashmir. The reasons are almost the same as the people in Sri Lanka are facing. We have the same laws as in Sri Lanka, Prevention of Terrorism Act, Emergency Regulations, and we are suffering in the same manner. About how India started. In 1947, when India and Pakistan were one and the colony of British, and there was a partition, and we have 565 provincial states in Ireland. They were under the British, they have their independent status. And Partition Act gave them the option either to join India or Pakistan. But unfortunately, we had yet to decide whether we would join India or Pakistan. India occupied our territory on 27th of October 1947. And the moment India occupied, 300,000 people were killed in the Jammu region, and after that, India started a continuity of killing and eliminating the people, and so far we have given 500,000 people. The reason for the killings is that the Kashmiris, which is a dispute as per the United Nations resolutions, because India moved to the United Nations and agreed that right to self-determination would be given to the people of Jammu and Kashmir. But for this right to self-determination, we have been struggling for the last 70 years. And people, once they come on the roads and demand for this right, the Indian occupation force kill people without any discrimination. In 1989, when there was no option left, as the people of Sri Lanka had, we opted for a gun. We picked up the gun, the people of Jammu and Kashmir picked up the gun, again as the occupation forces, when all the sources exhausted, when all the means exhausted. And what India did at that time, we had two communities. One was a community which is called Pandit community, and another community is a Muslim community. In 1990, the government of India, by design, approached this community and asked them to leave the state of occupied Jammu and Kashmir, which has been admitted a couple of these Hindus, Pandits rather, in different interviews, from Al Jazeera, CNN. They were asked to leave that that area, and the atmosphere was created such that no other community should live there except the Muslims. And after their migration to other areas, the Muslims were made the targets on the basis of their ethnicity. And till this time, from 1990, 100,000 people have been killed. This is a systematic, because it has been given legitimacy by the government of India under draconian laws, Armed Forces Special Powers Act and Public Safety Act. Unfortunately, the Armed Forces Special Powers Act is such a law which gives the occupational forces license to kill, and they can kill anybody on the mere suspicion that he has been against the India, against the integrity of the India. There have been arsons, there have been massacres. We have at least 11 to 20 massacres in which more than 200, 300 people were eliminated in one go. Since 2016, there was a mass uprising in occupied Jammu and Kashmir. One of our freedom fighters, when he was eliminated, people resisted. Unfortunately, what is wrong there has not been, there has been no definition till this date who is a freedom fighter and who is a terrorist. This is unfortunate, but I will say somebody is freedom fighter, is other terrorist, is somebody is freedom fighter. But for the last 1 year, there have been more than 2,000 people have been eliminated by the Indian occupation forces in a systematic manner. And unfortunate thing is that the courts in India are not taking cognizance, and we don't have any option except of this building. But unfortunately, this building has not given any kind of justice till this time. I share your pain, and I'm very much thankful for your work. Thank you, sir.